So you and Tupac continued your relationship, and you guys actually recorded the night before he gets killed.
Yeah, we recorded. I think it was the last song he ever recorded. I think Fame, and it was with me and Cocaine, and we recorded the song. You know, he's like, man, go get Cocaine. I went and got Cocaine, brought Cocaine back to the studio, re-recorded the song, and we went out, we was leaving the studio, and he was like, man, I'm finna go to Vegas to the Tyson fight. And he was like, the fight is gonna be real short because Tyson just gonna knock his ass out and then we gonna go party.
Right.
He was like, so hurry up and get out there. So I was like, cool, you know. So I be ready to go home and get ready to get dressed and all of that, and before I can get dressed and get out of the house, bam, I get a call saying Pac got shot. I'm like, shit, I'm stopped putting on cologne and motherfucking shoes and socks and shit, and was like, what the fuck? What did you just say? Like the home, you know, my manager, Chaz Hayes, had called me and told me. And so I was like, well, shit, I don't even want to go out over there now. I'm just going to lay down and go to sleep. You know, I'm tripping.
Right, because when we all heard it, it's like, well, yeah, Pac always gets shot, and he pulls through and makes a song about it and well, talks more shit.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, you know, and I remember even radio hosts, you know, in the Bay were even kind of making jokes about it. Like,
yeah.
Because no one really took it seriously at that point.
I thought he was going to die.
But then a few days later,
yeah,
he actually dies.
Yeah, I'm sitting up there thinking, you know, they was like, you know, you think he gonna die? I said, man, his will to live is too strong. He is not tripping on that shit, you know.
Well, you know, it's interesting because when you told me the story about the bloody blunt right before he died when he got shot at Quad, I interviewed Chris Carroll, who was the first responder cop in Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know if you saw this interview or not, but you know, he had no idea who any of these people were. He was like a white cop in Vegas on a bicycle, like, you know.
I came up to him, I was yelling at him to open the door. When I came up in the car, I could see that there was bullet holes all in the side of the door. I pulled the door open, and when I pulled it open, the guy sitting in the passenger seat, who turns out later to be Tupac, he kind of slumped out, came out with the door. So he's in the car, he's leaning against the door, and as I open the door, he kind of spills out. So he spilled out, and I just kind of grabbed him with one hand, and then I was pointing the gun at Shug with the other, because Shug is still trying to run up to me, and you know, the guy's clearly a threat. He was also just absolutely gushing blood out of the side of his head, but he's acting fine. I mean, he's not incapacitated in any way. In an instant, he went from trying to, you know, kind of squirming, looking at Shug, trying to get the words out, to where you could tell he physically just gave up. He just wasn't able to do it. And he just crossed that line into just quitting and being at peace. And he just kind of laid back and was calm and was no longer looking or trying to do anything. I looked at him once again. I said, what happened? Who did this? Who shot you? And now he's looking at me, so we're looking at each other in the eyes. And this is kind of the first time he's even acknowledging my presence. And he looked at me, and I could tell he was getting a breath together to tell me, and he looked me right in the eyes, and we looked at each other, and he said, fuck you. And he said it just like that, with an emphasis on that F.
So his last words were, fuck the police.
Fuck you, yeah. I could see that being his last words, too. I mean, we being so, you know, as a black man, you know, you can't say nothing, do nothing but say fuck the police.
Right, because you said a lot nowadays. Insults.
Yeah, I mean, I admit it's some cool, okay police, but the majority of them be assholes.
What's the worst thing that the police did to you?
I would say, like when they. They like planted some shit, you know. And, you know, I got off, but they like planted some shit.
Drugs?
Yeah. And the gun was mine. I didn't know nothing about the drug. Like, why would I have drugs in my car? I make rap money. you know, they got thrown out, like magically dismissed and thrown out and shit. You know, I was like, them motherfuckers trying to, you know. But I just didn't encounter them a lot, you know. Tried to stay away from as much as I could. I never looked at them like they was gonna protect me, ever. You know what I'm saying? I just looked at them like they gonna fucking kill me and arrest me and shit.
So you had to protect yourself?
Yeah.
Hence the guns.
It's like they put here to protect us, but who the hell is gonna protect us from them, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, it's hard to even think that a policeman is gonna help you if you're in a time of, only time I got shot, you know, I'm shot laying in a fucking ambulance and shit, and, you know, I'm looking like these motherfuckers, they probably laughing and shit, you know, these motherfuckers probably think this shit is funny, you know what I'm saying?
That happened later on.
Yeah.
Way later, and we'll, you know, I'll get to that.